And the problems on Palm Island have been turned into a powerful play. Beautiful One Day gives theatregoers an emotional account of the oppression suffered by our brothers and sisters on Palm Island and the events surrounding Mulrunji Doomadgee's death in custody. Queensland correspondent Jodan has more.
To the naked eye, the beauty of Palm Island cannot be denied. And terms such as a tropical paradise have been used to describe the picturesque piece of country. But for our people, the island has a grim history.
In 1918, they arrived on Palm Island. And I knew an old lady who was, she was 14 at the time. She was on board. She used to tell us all stories about it. And she said they were just herded on there and then made to go and find their own places on Palm Island. And they obviously did. They went into their various tribal groups, which were varied, said to be over 40 different tribal groups on board that day. And all displaced persons. They merged on board. They said, we're poor fellas now. We don't know what we are. And someone came up with the language word from their group, Bulgaman, meaning many different people, many tribal groups.
Auntie Magdalena Blackley joins other Palm Island locals Harry Rubin and Kylie Doomadgee, niece of Mulrunji, Rachel Mazza, and also Paul Dwyer and Jane Fegan, to bring the story of the island to life in Beautiful One Day, an emotionally moving piece of theatre which deals with issues that still confront our mob.
We're delivering to people an opportunity to open the door to conversation about everything, about how Aboriginal people were dealt with, our policy people were ruling our lives, signing away people's lives to send them to some reserve or some community or another.
The centrepiece performance surrounds the death in custody of Palm Island man Mulrunji Doomadgee, his story told through the perspective of his people.
And down the head, Chris, say, do you want some more of these, Mr. Doomadgee? Do you want some more of these, eh? Have you had enough?
Mulrunji's niece Kyla gives a beautiful performance. The dialogue is at times confronting, but crucial to how the events unfolded.
Why did he get away with f***ing murder? And he's still walking around free!
That's not an accident! That's not an accident!
The events following Doomadgee's death were covered heavily in the media, with a negative focus on the conflict between the community and the local police. The events are said to have been blown out of proportion.
It remained only a stand against the policeman, the police house where he lived, and the police station where he died. That was a so-called riot.
The big city provides an excellent stage to get the story out to a wider audience, but for the cast members, there was nothing like taking the story home to Palm Island.
It was amazing. It was one of the most phenomenal career highlights of my life, to be able to bring the play back to the people whose play it is. So that when I was standing on that stage, literally every word I said was said by someone who was in that room.
The production is only showing in Brisbane for 4 days, but the fight for justice for Palm Island continues.
That community are a community of resistance fighters. There's no way they're going to let this story get forgotten. This is going to keep going, and they're not going to stop until they get justice.
Jodan Perry for NITV News.